Great. So CETA is a network of scientists and engineers at the university who design programs and services for people in developing countries. And we like to think of ourselves as the analytics team in any major tech company, except that we're focused on public policy and poverty alleviation. And I want to say a few things about the problem that we're trying to solve, which is that too few of the programs that development agencies deliver are actually based on evidence. At the top of this slide, you see a quote from the Center for Global Development in DC, some of our colleagues, who point out that about $50 million are invested annually in rigorous research and evaluation of development programs, relative to $150 billion invested annually, or 130 in official development assistance. So that's about 0.5%. And just for comparison's sake, Google spends about 18% of its expenses on research and development. That was in 2014. Intel is spending about a quarter of its expenses on R&D. And so no private sector company would spend 0.5% on R&D to develop its products. And so we're trying to introduce more analytics and research into the development sector. There is an exception, and that's Mexico. This photo is from the Progresa program in Mexico. In the late 1990s, the Mexican government decided to incorporate rigorous randomized experiments, A-B testing, into the design of their biggest social welfare program called Progresa. And one of the CETA researchers, Paul Girdler, who's not here today, he was one of the first to work with the government on a randomized trial. They were adding innovative incentives into a cash transfer or welfare program to make it more cost-effectiveness. The outcomes were really compelling, and this approach has now been adopted by 30 countries on every continent in the world. What you're going to hear about today, which is really exciting, is the extension of this pretty seminal work by GiveDirectly and Paul Niehaus, and the introduction of new technologies to make these programs even more effective. So the Center for Effective Global Action, our model is to really diagnose challenges or threats in global development, design solutions, do a lot of A-B testing in the field, and then work with governments and NGOs to scale up the products. What we're trying to do is create very durable solutions for development. And we invest in portfolios of projects that allow us to make apples-to-apples comparisons between different anti-poverty approaches. So to improve poor farmers' incomes, should governments subsidize fertilizer, or should they give flexible credit products that are timed to the harvest cycles? Those are the kinds of questions that we're trying to answer. We have a number of portfolios of research, each with about 10 to 20 experiments or products being developed. We think that the portfolio approach is important for a couple of reasons. One is that it allows us to build visibility in the sector. It almost serves as a kind of branding and allows us to get buy-in from development practitioners. It also lets us hedge the risk that any one experiment will fail. So it's a useful approach, and this is how we kind of operate. I'm going to give you a couple of examples from our portfolio, things that have gone on to scale, which is pretty exciting for us. Our Evidence to Action event last year focused on agricultural development, and at that event we shared some of the big wins in the ag sector, including a credit product for small